The Anita Borg Institute's 2014 Women of Vision Abbey Award for Innovation goes to Tal Rabin. Tal is the manager and research staff member of the Cryptography Research Group at IBM's Thomas J. Watson Research Center, where her research has served as the foundation for cybersecurity and protection of individual privacy. Please enjoy this video about Tal.
Tal's work is very groundbreaking. Some of her work are the things that you can find in cryptography textbooks these days, and you can use that's part of our usual toolbox, the things that we always use.
Its underlying basis is math, and math has this really even this perfect thing. Everything is really, if it works, it's gorgeous. It just fits in a magical way together.
The goal is to be able to provide the security and privacy to interaction between machines, but definitely it's always not about the machines, it's about the human beings behind the machines.
The team that she has built here is a team that has international reputation. So it's one of the few places where people seek to come to work with the quality of people that she has brought together.
You know, she asks so many questions. I mean, she asks good questions, and she has a lot of insights.
She goes out after talent. She creates the environment. She looks after them very much like her own children in many ways.
But with Tal, it's always a little more than just work. It's the work, it's the working relationship with everybody.
She's helped form this group here, which is an amazing group. I came here largely because of her.
And when you put such great thought leaders in cryptography together, then you can, you know, you start making these quantum jumps and these leaps that you expect from researchers that really moves the science forward.
They're just extremely very talented people. I think that the whole is more than the sum of the pieces.
Yeah, I think in every place that Tal goes, everybody there is attracted to her. She generates this sense of community.
I always think about this group. It's part of the issue that I'm a woman. They always say that I'm a little bit motherish, that I sort of take care of them. And I wonder if that sort of contributes to what makes it a different kind of work environment.
I know it's important to her, being a woman in computer science and not having enough women in the field.
She began to care more about these issues, so the Women in Theory workshop that she's running started out by her wanting to just encourage more women to participate.
I want there to be more women around. It's not hard to go day after day and speaking only to men, but somehow it's unnatural.
We are all very proud of her and happy to have her working with us, taking care of us.
A perfect day for me would be when I've challenged myself on the intellectual level, when I've had good conversation with my team members, but that's the work part. But then going home and kissing my two daughters, that would make the day perfect.
And now, please give a warm welcome to President and CEO of the Anita Borg Institute, Tali Whitney, and to the Women of Vision Abbey Award winner for innovation, Tal Rabin.
Everyone, thank you so much for coming. I must say that it's a little bit hard to speak after seeing that movie. It made me a little bit emotional. I was told to give a 5-minute speech, and I'm going to stick to it. And if the other speakers speak longer, know that I could have said more also. So, okay. So I would like to start by, of course, thanking the Anita Borg Institute and the selection committee, who saw my contributions as meaningful and decided to award me with this huge honor. And of course, my co-winners, that I'm just blessed that I was put in such an amazing group. I want to thank the people who have stood by me throughout all or part of my life, because no one does it alone. My loving parents, Ruth and Michael, my sister, Sharon, my ex-husband, Boaz, and my friend, Revital. My group members over the years, and particularly Hugo, who you also saw in the film, who believed in me enough to nominate me for this award. And all my co-authors with whom I've shared the excitement of research. And of course, there are women, my women friends in the field, without whom this whole experience would have been completely different. They have made me smarter, better, and this journey extremely enjoyable. And above it all, my two daughters who are sitting here, Dana and Yael, they are two bright lights in my life, and they make everything worthwhile. So thank you. My path to this podium has been a learning journey. I did my graduate studies at the Hebrew University in Jerusalem, and there, at that time, we were a group of female students. There were about four or five of us. When I was writing this, I was trying to figure out if there were even any men students there, but I couldn't think of any. I don't know, maybe they just escaped my memory. We were friends, we studied together, we complained about our advisors, I'm sure you know that feeling. We shared our struggles, and above, most importantly, we celebrated each other's success and we pushed forward together. Towards the end of my PhD, when I had my one of my results, I went to STOCK, which is a leading theory conference, and there I met another group like mine. It was the Berkeley group, and they were five or six women. I envied them a little bit because they were all in theory, so they got to go to conferences together, while the women in Jerusalem, we were in different fields. And they were all amazing also. And then within a year or two, all of the women in these two groups graduated and got wonderful jobs in leading institutions in Israel and in the US. Basically, we all did great. And I thought to myself, that I don't want to be considered as a woman. I will do it all on merit. And clearly, when you are good, you can succeed. All these women have proved it. And I had gone once to a women's conference just after I started at IBM, and I vowed never to return. And I thought that it sort of claimed benefits for women just because they were women. But with time, I grew older, and possibly a bit wiser, but just a little bit wiser. But the one thing that I did understand is that I misattributed the success of the women in these two groups only to their talent. The talents, of course, played a role, but the group played an indisputable part as well. We flourished from the support that we had given one another, and it enabled us to persevere. We instilled in each other confidence, and from seeing each other move forward, we learned that it was possible. And thus, I had gone from dismissing women power to understand it that we needed like oxygen. And furthermore, that we should take any and every advantage that we are given due to the fact that we are women and make the most of it. Maybe a day will come when processes will be completely gender neutral. That would be great. But even if that day does arrive, the benefit that we can get from standing by each other will never disappear. I would like to finish with one piece of advice. I do not label what I give as advice, but people who know me closely say that I give advice all the time and expect it to be followed. So, anyway, the one bit of insight that I think I have into being a working woman is don't have guilt. It is not a productive sentiment. I find that women feel a lot of guilt. Why am I staying at work instead of going with my friends? Or if you do the opposite, why did I go to the party when there was so much to complete at work? It's of course very easy advice to give, but not very hard, but much harder to follow. But just don't get into those thoughts. Once you make the decision on what to do, just go with it and embrace it. Otherwise, you will not enjoy anything that you do. And if you are also a mother, then the choices are even harder. But I want to tell you that I was lucky to be raised by the best mother, at least the best mother for me, and she was a working mother. Growing up, I had the sense that she was always there for me. and when I needed her. And she was also extremely successful in her career. And through that experience, I have learned that you can devote to your career and still do a great job as a mother. Just make wise choices on how to spend your time and don't feel guilty about what you decide. So given that I know that this whole thing isn't that easy, I really want to conclude by saying that I applaud you all. Thank you very much.